Alright, so we began bank management. And we start today chapter 1. And chapter 1 is simply overview. Overview is the same as introduction.
Yes. We should write things.
Well, you should take notes, yes. I mean, you've been a student for a long time. You do what you think is best for your learning. It is in the best possible way. You can write, you don't have to write, maybe you can watch it on YouTube later, take the notes later, it's all up to you. Okay?
What I said previously, if we got the book or slides,
you can write on the slides.
But we are working, if this is my book, right. We are here and writing notes. Because this book we keep.
Right.
For future.
Right.
For the either book, either slides, PowerPoint.
Right. For the moment, you just pay attention. You take short notes. Okay. Do what most students in the world do. Okay. You do your best. I do my best. All right. Later on, I adjust and adapt to you. You adjust and adapt to me. Okay? So, banks and financial institutions are, first and foremost, source of credit. Source of credit. If you need funds, you get it from them. In general, you say that they are source of
money.
Financing. Which means basically source of money. Again, the financing can come as stocks, it can come as bonds, it can come as mortgages, it can come in many different ways and forms which are legal forms, okay? Financial forms. Some involve debt. Others involve equity. Banks mostly deal with debt. Alright, let's see what else. Financial institutions and bank deal with payments. Make a payment from you to me, or in this case from the university to me. The university makes a bank payment, a bank transfer. That's very simple. Now, not maybe here, but in other countries they use check and checking. And I don't want to get a piece of paper, it's a check, we can write a check. So, they provide checking and checking services. Much more common, pretty much anybody has here, a bank account. Bank account. And let's call it bank card. It's a plastic piece of paper.
Secure the money of the others.
Debit card. And credit card.
Okay.
Again, source of credit. The big one is
loans.
loans could be corporate, these are for big major companies. They could be small business, small business enterprises. Yes, they will be loans to the government.
Individual.
And individual we call consumer
loans.
Okay, consumer credit. Now, the consumer loan could be mortgage. Mortgage, which means secured with real estate. And the other one could be installment. Sometimes one L here, depending on British or American. Installment loan is you take one loan and then you make monthly installment payments. Could be 6, 12, you know, maybe you want to buy a MacBook or a car or whatnot, and they can give you a 36-month loan or 6-month installment loan. Installment means that the monthly payment is always the same. Let's see what else we have. They could be providing also for, I can actually add it here, working capital. Working capital is the short-term capital that a business uses for normal operations, usually involving payment of some services and inventory. Alright, so these are some of the main functions that they do. There may be more. So, next is number two. It's a very tough question, actually, very difficult question. What is a bank? Bank is in a definition. And actually, I've been teaching banking for 20-25 years. Students usually struggle with a simple question. Actually, bankers struggle with a simple question of what is a bank, okay? It's a place where you get money. Well, what about the mutual fund? What about exchange fund? In other words, it's very important to understand that there are 15-20 different types of financial institutions. Each is very different, and it's very easy to confuse bank with some other.
It's a place which provides financing for the institution and individual.
Okay, and that's not good enough.
It's the place where investor can be meeting to each other, and then like intermediate between investors.
Okay, so now you correct, let's write it out. Now, but you guys come closer. Now, you see, now you're facing the difficulty of the problem. You provide the definition of financial intermediary. And financial intermediary is associated with any type of financial institutions where people with sources of funds meet with those that need funds. In other words, you have people who have excess funds or surplus funds and those with shortage of funds. This is just a financial intermediary. Now, let me see. Okay, here's what I'll do for you. Okay, here's what I'll do for you. There is called commercial bank. Okay, next one is money center bank. Next one is community bank.
Okay.
Oh, savings bank. Cooperative bank. There's a whole bunch more, and I'll get to it, okay? Oh, there is mortgage bank. All right, let's see what else we got. Oh, man. Merchant bank. Again, I'll be sooner getting over these. And investment bank. Then there's international bank, wholesale bank, retail bank, and whatnot. There are member banks, so a whole bunch of banks. Well, now let's draw the line over here to explain the financial intermediary. You have funds. Mutual fund. A whole bunch of people get together. Okay, there's a fund. They put in their money, and the fund invests in stocks and bonds. Do they meet together? Do they have surplus of funds? Yes. Do they have investment? Yes. Do they buy stocks or bonds or mortgages or even possibly loans, not for a future month? Yes. So, mutual fund is also a financial institution, but it's not a bank. Next one is pension fund. Again, is a financial institution which accepts funds from working people, invests those funds, and pays back, we say, disbursement after a while when they retire. You may have a hedge fund. Hedge fund. This is like a mutual fund, but hedge fund is unregulated. They can invest in anything, stocks, bonds, currencies, commodities. They can use a lot of leverage. They can invest in derivatives. Have you studied derivatives? Not yet? Okay. Futures, options. In other words, they can use a lot of speculation. They can make or take short positions. Have you studied shorting? You short the stock, short the bond. In other words, they can bet that the asset is going down in price. So you got a hedge fund. Okay? So, you have a lot of other institutions. Insurance. Insurance companies. Insurance companies. Okay?
This all under investment bank or different places?
But these are all very, very different. Next one is, again, investment bank and commercial banks. Again, the problem is now, what is the difference between all of these and these? All right. And now comes a straightforward, short and easy definition. For a commercial bank, in order to be a bank, back historically, legally, it must, the key definition is, Here. Accept deposit. Commercial banks accept deposits. Okay? So that's the first key characteristic. The second key characteristic of a commercial bank, so I'm covering only that one, is commercial. Commercial loans.
Giving loans.
Yes, making loans, not any kind of loans. Commercial loans. This is letter A, L here. Commercial. So he has to make commercial loans. Okay. Now, it may be making only mortgages. If it makes mortgages, it's not a commercial bank. Okay. It becomes either mortgage bank or mortgage company. Mortgage company. Okay. Now, it may be making loans but not accepting deposits. This will be like a trade union, where you have only teachers. Teachers get together, they put in their money into the union, okay? Trade or credit. Let's put it more like credit union. Teachers put their money in and then they borrow, okay? So that's possible, okay? It could be a credit company. A credit company will usually make small business loans, or it will make personal loans, we call these consumer loans, but does not accept deposits. Okay? So, there are a lot of institutions which accept deposits but don't make loans, commercial loans. There are a lot of institutions that can make commercial loans but don't accept deposits. So there are many different variations on the deposit. For example, a wholesale bank and a money center bank usually does not accept, now we call these retail deposits, but they may be accepting deposits from other commercial banks. In other words, it's important to understand that there are 20-30 different types of financial institutions. Each has a different characteristic. Of course, each has a different risk. They'll have each different proportions of financing, meaning debt and equity. Deposit is a very special type of debt. It's an obligation to pay immediately, which is very different from all other obligations and liabilities. So this is how accept deposit and make loans. All right, so definition can run in three different ways. The first definition could be based on functions. You can define bank according to the function, and it could be the lending function, makes credit. You could also define a bank based on the deposit function, okay? Now, back in the old days, a bank was considered based entirely on the deposit function. If you put your money, it's called a bank. If it's accepting deposit, it's called a bank. Bank, just a bank. Later on, from the function came the legal definition, where just putting the money there wasn't enough because there were other things. So the legal definition became accepting deposit and making commercial loans, because commercial loans were not secure. These were unsecured loans, and unsecured loans posed very special risks. So when they defined a commercial bank, they wanted to differentiate it from a financial institution like a mortgage bank here, which would be providing loans secured by real estate. And mortgage banks will be considered a lot safer because they had the security of the house or the real estate
assets.
They were secured by assets, and commercial loans were usually not secured. secured by that. Now, they may be separately, the commercial loans may be short term for working capital, they may be long term for fixed asset. Again, the problem was that they needed to separate those secured from unsecured loans. And they were not worried too much about mortgage banks going bankrupt. But they were worried about commercial banks going bankrupt, which were accepting deposits, okay? Now, in recent decades, and that's part of the trends I'll be explaining later on, in recent decades, most of these have merged together. A bank is now functioning like a savings bank, and like a mortgage bank, like a commercial bank, like a consumer credit bank. In other words, today's commercial banks make all the major types of loans, and the commercial part is actually very small, okay? But nevertheless, they have separate laws, separate rules, separate regulations. All right, let's see what else we have. So, by function, by legal, and three, by services. You really need to understand that key definition and what it means.
So,
yes?
Why does it mean it like...
Okay, do your thing.
Sorry.
All right. I already covered a lot of section 3, which is financial system and competing. So, 3, and now it's 3.1. What are the roles or the functions that they have? So, the main function is intermediation. Remember, all of these are intermediaries, including the hedge fund and the mutual fund and the pension fund and the mortgage company. They're all, but the main function is the intermediation of those with surplus to those with shortage or deficit.
Well, between the...
They stand between...
The stuff of depositor and
yes.
Borrowers. Interpination.
Right, so...
On what?
On the one side...
Investor and borrowers.
On the one side...
Yes.
On the one side are the... Savers. Saver is the same as depositor.
Depositor, yes.
So, they go through the financial intermediary, and on the other side are
entrepreneurship.
Users.
Users, yes.
So, these are the savers of funds, these are the user. The user may be the company, the government, the individual, the household, okay? So, what are the main four services? Service number one is payments. I already covered number two, risk protection services. May be associated with accidents, may be associated with exchange rates, may be associated with prices. Yes?
Some country in Europe.
Mm-hmm.
Europe is funding Greek.
Yes.
But there is no protection because there is...
When you say protection, you have to say protection from God, protection for the investor, for the creditor, for the depositor, for the government, for the borrower. Protection for whom?
There is no protection for when people need investment or give salary, like country, big country,
yes.
It's need money.
Right.
Money coming from the bank.
Right. So
if there is no money in the bank,
right.
So the country is not growing, no new investment, nothing.
Right.
So it's grow is die.
Right.
But so if there is corruption, people take money cash and go other country.
Alright, so what you are explaining right now is that financial institutions affect growth, affect economic growth, right?
This is a recording now.
Yeah, that's okay. Yes. I was asking something very simple. What are the main services? Again, you see, it's very important to understand something which is relevant.
Yeah.
Relevant. For example, right now is 7 o'clock in 10 minutes. Is it true? Yes. Is it correct? Yes. But it's not relevant. It doesn't matter. Not part of what we're studying. Hey, it's January 22nd, 2018. Is this correct? Yes. Is it true?
Yes.
Is it a fact? Yes. But it doesn't matter. It's irrelevant. We're not concerned. Right now, we're concerned with bank functions, okay, and bank services. So they provide payment services. Yes, it's true. If the bank goes down, people lose money. And they can't. So it's very true, but it's not relevant. Right now, we want to know what are the other two main services which they offer? Service. Number three, liquidity services.
Liquidity means provide cash.
Correct. It provides cash, usually short term, when you really need it until you get your own income. If you're an individual, maybe by the 15th or 20th, you need a little extra money. They can give you money until you get your salary. Or maybe you want to buy a car, they'll give you a 6 month, or let's say a laptop. They may be some expensive laptop, which will cost $2,000 or $12,000. And you want to borrow for two or three. So that's liquidity. It's especially for a business. A business may have inventory, it may have customers, it might be selling, but it might be just short-term having hard times to pay the salaries until they sell the product. Okay? So this is all liquidity.
Faster liquidity, faster expansion.
Right, that's separate. Again, another fact which is not relevant. Right now, the relevant question is, which is service number four, the fourth important service?
Payment service, risk protection, liquidity service.
And the last one is actually the first, credit services.
Credit, yeah.
Okay, so these are the four credit services.
What does mean credit exactly? Can you?
Okay, that's a very good question.
Tell me exactly what does credit mean, what does debit mean?
Oh, no. Okay. All right. That's a very different question.
Okay.
Credit,
yeah.
In banking and finance means a loan.
A loan
is lending money and borrowing money. So, on the one side is the lender, call him creditor. On the other side is the borrower. Credit is associated, you give money For?
Bank is creditor.
Hmm?
I am the borrower.
Yes, so credit is associated with a loan. Every credit has a lender, which is exactly the same as creditor.
Same meaning, creditor, lender, same meaning, huh?
Yes, it's exactly the same meaning of lender and creditor.
It's provide credit.
Yes,
and it's providing me credit.
On the other side is borrower. So what is
provide
a credit?
Money. Provide
yes.
credit.
It is an amount of money lent for a particular period of time, usually with a particular payment schedule. They can say you must pay every month so much, or they say you can pay up to any amount within 6 months, or it could be a single one-time credit with a one-time payment. You borrow now, and after 1 month, you pay back so much, okay, extra. So there are different types of credit, but it's all associated that you'll have to return within a given time the main amount, which we call principal.
Okay, if we,
And the other part could be fee, but in general, if it's a loan, we call it interest. Okay, question. So that's credit means loan. Now, there is a completely different word in finance and in accounting where credit is the opposite of debit, right? Okay. Now, this is shockingly simple. This is the simplest thing, the first thing you learn in accounting. You have in accounting an account, and this represents a D account. Debit means DB means left side. That's it. Left side. That's the meaning of debit. No more, no less. And credit means
right side.
Right side. That's it. Now, for an asset, debit means increasing. So debit cash means cash going up. Okay. For an inventory, debit means inventory go up.
Does it mean cash? Credit mean loan?
No. 10 times no.
Okay, 1 minute. Well,
debit means left side, credit means
right side.
Right side.
No, bank. I have 2 cards in the bank.
Okay.
I have credit card and debit card. Debit
Correct.
Card, when I have cash,
right.
I'm using my debit card.
All right.
With my wallet is empty,
right.
I'm using my credit card.
All right. Yes.
Credit card means it's loan.
Correct. Well, yes and no. All right. There is a chapter 5 which will study bank accounting, bank income statements, bank balance sheet. We'll get to that. You see, here's the thing. I can go about it right now. I can spend a little time and explain. If you have a bank account, okay, in the bank, is the bank account asset, credit, asset, liability, income? What is your bank account in the bank?
Current account.
Yes, a current account. What does it represent?
Nothing. Just my salary coming in this
right,
account.
In your salary.
Using only.
Right. Now the question changes. What is for the commercial bank? Could be Islamic bank. For the commercial bank, what does your bank account represent? What is your current account represent for a commercial bank or any bank? Short answer, liability. So, bank deposit. Deposit is a liability. Is a
liability, yes, obligation.
Is a liability.
Obligation to other liability.
Right, so when you deposit $100 or dirham in your bank account, the bank owes you 100. Therefore, your deposit for the commercial bank is a liability. Okay? Now, if it's a liability and this represents the deposit, a liability account, when you credit the accounts, this means that the liability increases. So, if you deposit 1,000, they will say credit 1,000.
For the bank.
For the bank, yes. We always think from the point of view of the financial institution. So,
but it is debit for me
from the point of view of the
bank.
Okay. So, becomes the accounting entry becomes cash 1,000 and deposit. So, debit cash 1,000, credit deposit 1,000. Okay, from the bank's point of view, from the bank's accounting point of view. From your point of view, it will be a mirror image.
Yes.
Every credit for the bank represents for you a debit and vice versa. So, in this case, you put money, deposit money, the bank credits your account. So, when the university deposits my salary, I receive a message that the bank has credited my account with the amount of the salary. Next one is withdraw 500. When you withdraw 500, the bank debits. So, this credit has very little to do with the other credit. Don't confuse even for a second that credit means whatever, you know, loan. Yes, here credit means a loan. Now, let's do the
following. Left and right.
Yes, in accounting it means
left, debit right.
Means
yes,
yes. Left, and credit means right. Now, when you get a credit, let me show you how you get credit in bank accounting, because again, that's important and yes, you'll take a shot. Yes, you want to take a good shot, okay? All right, I'll do this here for you.
That's it.
All right, so let's do this thing here now. That's okay, that's later, worry about it, okay? Now, you go to the bank, you ask for a loan of 10,000, okay? You ask for a loan of 10,000, which is the same as asking for a credit of 10,000.
Yeah, if you continue.
Right. So, now the question is, the bank gives you a credit of 10,000, okay? The question is, what is the bank's accounting entry? What will the bank debit? No, what will the bank debit and what will the bank credit? So what's going to be the debit, what's going to be the credit? If the bank gives you 10,000 loan or 10,000 cash,
debit for the bank.
Debit what? Credit what?
Cash. So cash will be credit for the entry.
Okay, well, they're not going to give you cash, that's a different story. What's the debit, what's the credit? So, the bank will debit loans, loans, consumer loans, let's say 10,000. Well, what's the credit?
Credit, the cash of the bank is credit.
Not yet.
10,000.
Not yet. Consumer loans, credit becomes deposit. Deposit, credit,
yeah.
10,000. So, to create the loan, all they do is they credit your account with 10,000. Now, you're thinking in terms of taking the money out of the bank, right? If you take a loan, now, taking the loan is a two-step process. The first is crediting your account. Now, the second step is you actually withdraw the money. How do you withdraw the money? What is the debit? What's the credit in withdrawing the money from your bank account? What's the debit? Deposit?
Debit, deposit, and consumer loan would be credit. Now, this is which account? Now, sorry.
Deposit 10,000. Cash 10,000. So, a credit transaction involves two separate steps. The first step is they give you the credit. In other words, you're authorized. They give you the credit by crediting your deposit account. Remember, when they give you 10,000 cash or credit, you don't have to take it the same day. Maybe take it tomorrow. Maybe take it after 1 week. Maybe take it after 3 months. If they give you 10,000 credit, maybe tomorrow you take only 5,000 to pay the salaries, and after 3 weeks or 3 months you take the other 5,000. Okay? So the lending, meaning the loan or the credit operation, is completely separate from the cash withdrawal operation. And the first one is when the loan is authorized. Your loan is approved and they credit your account with 10,000, meaning they give you credit 10,000. You can withdraw it the same day or the next day, or 3 months or 6 months later. You can draw it in 1, 2, 3, or 5 separate withdrawals. Okay? So, when you say you get a credit, means they credited your deposit. This is technically called bank deposit.
The first two column is for me. That's deposit and cash for the bank, you mean?
Look, all this accounting is from the point of view of the commercial bank. This is how the commercial bank will do its own accounting. Now, if you have your own business, we can do your accounting separate. And it will be a mirror image. Here, you're gonna have a deposit in the bank, okay? So, you're gonna debit your deposit account, okay? Later, when you withdraw, you're gonna credit your, when you withdraw for the bank, it's debit deposit, credit cash. For you, it's gonna be the mirror image. Debit cash, credit deposit. Okay? So, a deposit account, remember, is always a debit and a credit. It's a debit for the owner, for you, and it's a credit for the commercial bank. Every cash account is always a debit and a credit. If you deposit money, for you it's credit, for the bank it's debit. And the other way around, if you withdraw money, it becomes for you, you withdraw money means you get the money. Debit cash for you, for the bank is credit. So every transaction between you and the bank is always a mirror image. Same thing is between suppliers of, let's say, any kind of supply, accounts payable and accounts receivable. So, for example, you're two different businesses, he sells to you on credit. When he sells on credit, he gets account receivable, you get account payable. He will debit account receivable, you will credit account payable. So, they're always mirror images of each other, and the confusion can come whether you think point of view or from your point of view. Now, when we study banking and finance, we always
think it from the
bank's point of view, as if you are inside the bank and you're doing accounting for the bank. All right, more questions? No. So, we're back to the four main services which the bank provides. Let me see what else what we have in here. So, and let's see, okay, that's good enough.